I had to wash down a whole pork chop.
I like the idea of stuffing them. I never thought about stuffing them that Ray showed.
A little cornbread stuffing.
Yeah, it's a really good idea. Mm-hmm. I might want to try the butterfly in them.
With some herbs. Hey, Mark Charles.
Hey.
How are you doing?
Good.
Happy spring.
I'm bringing an oldie but a goodie back. You haven't seen
it in
a long time.
You're looking sharp today. I like this shirt.
Thank you. Just bought it yesterday for today.
Looking very spring-like, mister. Hey, that camera right there. They want to see you right there. There you are. Hey, you are bringing back an idea that you
designed
many years ago.
About 12 years ago.
But now it's kind of been new and updated, right?
It's been new and updated. So it is the Flexi spatula that has a blade running here, running there. It's got the offset handle, so now you can slice and serve. We give you new colors, a new punch-out design. We give you sheets. Set of two, you're going to get a long and a rectangle and a square. We have all the colors down front for you, lined up for you to show them if you
Please,
would like to
show
them.
Please, thank you. So what we're doing is giving you two of these slice and serves.
Yep.
And they both come with their little protective cover. These are, now, do you recommend dishwasher for these or no?
You can put them in the dishwasher, but they slide right off. It's a top shelf dishwasher.
Yeah, so top shelf. This is red. Here it is in the black. Don't forget, we also have it for you in blue.
Yeah, which is more of a turquoise.
Correct. Then seafoam.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally on the end, orchid purple.
Orchid purple.
That's our most limited.
So what's unique about this is a spatula meets a knife. So these are Japanese steel knives with coated. You know the Kunrikan knives you've been using all these years. When I created this, it was like, well, let's put a knife on a spatula. Why is that important? Because, by the way, it's a knife, folks. This can cut through all of that easily. You can actually cut through bread because it is serrated without any ripping.
Yeah.
Look, there's no ripping on that bread at all. So remember to show you, there's a knife here. See the, let's show you, there we go. Knife there. And there's a knife there. Why is that important? Let's go over to why we created it. If you have something, whether it's temptations, metal, if it is glass, you now have a knife. You can go in there with your baked goods and actually cut the slice that you want, however length you want, and actually go in there and scoop it out and serve it.
Now, one reason perfect you can get square. In there and get a perfect, one reason we're not sacrificing the first brownie or the first slice of cake is because the spatula, Mark Charles, you designed it to be flexible.
Flexible, so this
so
is
it's able
give.
To bend underneath yep. that first piece and it doesn't rip it or tear it when you go to pull it out. 200 of these are now gone. I want to remind you that every item on air and online until 3:59 p.m. Eastern time today is 5 pay or better.
How about
that would
getting
be five easy payments in this case,
David
Mark Charles.
David size lasagna.
Yeah, right? 5 payments of $4.65. Now, that is a David-sized piece.
But I love the fact that whether it is savory or sweet, you can get in there. Remember, the offset is important because when you're getting deep inside of there, it's going to go inside the pan. You can cut it, slice it this way. Look, this slices this way or this way. And then you can get in there. There's a smaller piece. Look at this. Look at the slice on there. Look how beautiful. It cut everything without ripping it. Take it right out.
And that
out.
First piece is always the hardest one to get
always
out.
Always the hardest one.
Out of the corners.
Yep.
And this flexible blade will help you
okay.
do that.
So,
now, Mark Charles, your friend and mine, Lucinda Scalaquin.
Which we love dearly.
And on Mad Hungry, where she does those Insta stories where she cooks.
Yep.
Have you seen them?
Yes, I
They're
do.
Amazing. Just yesterday, she put one up making spinach pie with phyllo dough, sheets of phyllo dough. Once this comes out of the oven, you'll be able to use this to slice and serve.
Correct. And look at the edge, guys. I'm cutting this clean as a whistle, whether it's a frittata, whether it is a baked good. And here's the thing. If you're not baking stuff and you want to go and actually serve things that you bought, you can actually use on anything from porcelain to china to your Lennox. Look, I can slice this and serve this. Beautiful. Because of these teeth that are on there, I'm not ruining anything. Let's go to the big birthday cake. How many times you buy a big birthday cake and you want to cut the sheet cake? Look at this. Cuts beautifully both ways. And then let's give you another little square. And I'm able to serve, whether it's the middle, whether it's the end, perfectly every single time.
May I give you an Alan Rosen trick?
What's that?
He wipes the spatula in between each slice.
Okay.
So you get a super clean slice. Now, that's not to say that I won't eat this. Because I will.
I like that idea.
But if you wipe it off in between each slice, then you get a perfectly clean slice of cake.
We
right?
love that, right?
And I would not suggest
lick
licking.
All the icing.
Well, I wouldn't do that because it's sharp.
That's true. But your finger.
If it's on my finger.
Okay, then that's good. This will work in your cast iron. It'll work in your glass. You saw me work in my temptations, where this metal bakeware, it works in anything.
So I'm going to get back to that cake. Don't be misled.
Don't be misled.
Here it is in the red, most popular. Black, and in a moment, guys, we'll bring Stacey's mic up. She's got a question from the chat. Here it is in the blue. We call that blue?
We're calling it blue, but it's turquoise, yep.
Yeah, then we've got it in the seafoam green.
Yep.
And you want orchid purple?
Orchid.
Only 1,200. Miss Stacy, let's bring Miss Stacy's mic up.
Nice and springy. Go.
Stacy, what's happening?
Since it's a Japanese steel blade.
Yep.
And the serration, can you sharpen this in the sharp sharp?
Yes, as on the serration side,
right.
Not on the straight edge side.
Right, okay.
So it's like a regular serrated knife. It is got the serration of bread. Why it's important, the serration, because when you're doing cakes, when you're doing lasagnas, you need to cut through pastas and the density of cakes and you don't want to rip through it. So that's why you need the serration. And it's important to note you can actually sharpen the serration with a sharp shark as long as you use the serration side, not the straight edge.
If
you
love store-bought cake. Can I just say that?
I know you do. Look at this, cornbread.
I think we should do a recipe this summer.
If you guys are doing cornbread.
Make a trifle.
Ooh, I like that idea.
Be good. Yeah, we'll make a sauce to go with it.
You know what's great about you is everything's got a food purpose.
Yes.
You know, right? And getting underneath there and the cornbread, and I mean, look, I cut out a perfect triangle because of that blade. Look, I'm not ripping or tearing my food. I'm using it inside my pan that easily. And by the way, my favorite, look what Chef Mitch did for us today. By the way, he already warned me.
He made a rice cereal treat.
But not just any rice. Double the marshmallows, almost to browning, double the butter, and he told me that you should really try these.
I can't wait.
So,
you know what, when I was in junior high school, we took some kind of class
Take
where we made these, but we mixed peanut butter in them too.
This is peanut, I never did that.
Yeah, you can do peanut butter in them too.
Chef Mitch said he used to do it for his kids, and he's known for it. It's only a special occasion he does this. He doesn't do it often, because it's not, you know, it's not fat-free, let's put it that way. What do you think? I haven't tried it, can I try it? He said to me, he goes, make sure you serve David this rice cake.
Are you kidding me?
Oh my word.
Wow. All right, you go right, I'm going left. Happy dance.
Happy dance.
Get it.
Thank you, Chef Mitch. So remember,
amazing.
These have the sheath. The sheaths are important because these are sharp blades. They are Japanese steel. We put like a silicone high bake on both sides so things are gonna slip off. Nothing's gonna stain. It's not gonna keep the odors. And it's something you can use over and over and over and over again.
Let's take a look at colors as I tell you three, how many? 3,200 of these are now gone.
Okay.
Take advantage of this. We've got red, the black, the blue. This is seafoam green. And in the orchid purple, only 1,100 left to go around. Mark Charles, always a pleasure. You're going to be coming back a little later.
Yep. With another one of my creations.
Now, you need to know about this Easy Pay. This Easy Pay goes way into the show. I know. How good is
and
that?
And this rice thing is going away at the end of this episode.
No, that's going away right now because you've eaten it.
Stacey, you have to try this.
Hey, I've got to, Stacey, you got to try the rice cereal treats.
Like, seriously.
Hey, are we going to, am I updating or is Stacey updating?
I have to give Stacey a piece.
Okay, let me update you real quickly. The pork steaks have sold out. You all are not going to be disappointed. That is crazy. Stacey, I'm going to bring you a whole slice.
You're like seriously the best.
I got to take care of my friends. Come on.
Oh, boy.
Told you. We love Chef Mitch. Thank you, Chef Mitch.
What?
He might have brought you a bite.
Oh. Yeah, I gotta outdo me.
I bought you a whole, well, you do cookies or anything.
I'm not even a fan.